gentlemen, welcome to Apeer High School. It's out of this year's regional tournament. At this time, would you please stand? We'll start with the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by a moment of silence, then we'll have our national anthem. Please join me in the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Let's have a moment of silence.
All right, basketball fans, we are back for the third and final round of the 2A South Regional Basketball Tournament here at Akron, Arkansas. Coach Bowman back tonight for the games. Going to have the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. James Spradlin, with me for this first game of the afternoon. He's been here all week watching games. We've both seen these teams. Hopefully we'll have a good game to start it off with. We've had some really good games so far in the tournament. And James, this Woodlawn team, been banged up. Looks like everybody who was hurt is out there playing. I know that Holt got hurt yesterday, had an elbow issue. She's got a big sleeve on. And Fitzgibbon Looks like that ankle is still swollen up, but she is moving a little better than she did yesterday.
Yeah, that's going to be real important for them, for those two to be able to go.
Absolutely. So Spring Hill is going to win the tip, and they'll start it off. I know this is going to be today's games are usually the toughest ones because everybody's exhausted by this point. Game three in 3 days or 4 days, and everybody's tired, especially these teams that are traveling
right.
Far distances. Even if you stay the night somewhere close, it's still, you know, you're not sleeping in your own bed.
That's right.
It's tough.
And for these two, they're coming into this game off of losses.
Shot right there. That was Adams from the corner with a big shot to start the scoring off for Spring Hill. There's Holt from the top of the key trying to answer. No good. And Spring Hill's going to get the rebound. They're going to push it up the floor. Yeah, this third place game is always a tough one because you just lost and you're bummed that you lost, frustrated. But you got to come out here and play. As you said earlier before the game, the loser of this game is probably going to get Mansfield.
Yeah.
In the state tournament, and that's a game that you don't want in the first round.
No.
Get a travel right there. Yeah. It's like she bobbled the ball, just couldn't quite get it up fast enough.
So. Yeah, it's going to be important for one of these teams or both to get something going early. Kind of get their mojo back a little bit.
There's Fitzgibbon on the drive. She lost the ball, but again, she looks like she's moving better than she did yesterday.
So yeah.
That's a good sign. She did a lot of that in the first game until she twisted her ankle, and she didn't do much any of that yesterday. Dixon from the corner, no good. Spring Hill with the rebound, pushing it up the floor. Another three from Spring Hill, just off the back of the eye.
Yeah, Spring Hill's not afraid to shoot the three.
No, they're not.
They like to put it up there.
McWhorter gets the rebound. Woodlawn's going to bring it up the floor. Still 3-0, Spring Hill. Dixon in, gets blocked, and Spring Hill's going to come away with it. And then Dixon's going to be a little out of control coming down, and she's going to pick up the foul. You know, that's another thing in the evening games during the week, the gym's a little more rocking.
Yeah,
it's
it is.
Quiet in here today as
yes.
compared to the rest of the games, too. So you kind of have to get your own, you know, hype.
Yeah, it's earlier in the day, too, than what you've been playing.
Yep. Just still there by McWhorter, almost. She didn't pull it away. And Thompson from Spring Hill picks it up. Loose ball and gets the basket. Spring Hill going to put a little pressure on.
Oh.
And we're going to get a foul on Tyree there.
Holt is still favoring that. That elbow.
Yeah, you can tell neither one of them are 100%, but like I said, this is a big game for them. You really need to win this one for state tournament seeding purposes, and they're going to give everything they can. Shot was blocked there by Spring Hill, but Woodlawn keeps it, gets it to McWhorter, and she's going to put the layup up. No good, but she'll get fouled, and she's going to go to the line to shoot two. That'll be the first foul on Purefoy for Spring Hill. McWhorter gets the first free throw to go. And Woodlawn finally gets on the board. Second one goes as well. Kick out for three.
No good. Offensive rebound. Springhill hits the deck. We got bodies on the floor. We're going to get a jump ball. I like the effort right there. Pressure. They skip it up ahead. And then Woodlawn is going to slow it down a little bit. Oh. Still drive. Tough shot. Fitzgibbon with the rebound. Misses it. Springhill's going to pull it away. They'll look to push it up the floor. They're going to skip it ahead. Nice little move to get to the basket. And they're going to get a foul.
Yeah, I think Fitzgibbon is definitely more active in today's game.
Yeah.
That's good for them.
Yeah, I agree. First free throw, no good for Adams. First sub of the game. Zacharias is going to come in for Spring Hill. And Adams will get on his second free throw to fall. There's the skip over the press again. And Woodlawn will set up the offense. Down inside to Fitzgibbon. She'll get fouled. She hits the deck.
That's at least the second time she's been on the deck.
Yeah. Fitzgibbon looking to drive. She's going to go up for two, which looks a lot like what we saw the first game until she got injured. Right there is her driving to the basket, drawing a foul, and going to the line to shoot some free throws. So Fitzgibbon at the line shooting two. First one's a little short. Flower is going to check in for Spring Hill. Fitzgibbon gets the second one to go. And Spring Hill has the ball. Woodlawn putting a little pressure on as well.
I think that's the difference in this game, too. Woodlawn pressured a lot in their first game and not so much last night.
Yeah. Block right there by McCormick, I believe. And here comes Holt. She's pushing it up the floor. She loses it, and she's going to travel with it. It's like she was trying to go over the top with a little Euro step there and just lost it. Gets over the top of the press. Trap in the corner. Loose ball. Fitzgibbon comes out of there with it. And she's looking to push it. Out to Dixon in the corner. Three ball up. No good. Spring Hill with a rebound. And Dixon's going to pick up another foul. I think that's her second already. Dixon's going to check out with two fouls.
Tyree and Coffey are coming in for Spring Hill.
And Hysaw will come in for Woodlawn. So here we go. I don't know what happened or what I missed. Oh, I guess I added that to the wrong score. Sorry. Falling asleep here. It's early. Come in some slack. Spring Hill. Down inside in McWhorter. Oh, tough shot right there. Spring Hill had a hand on the ball. Looked like it was going to be a block. And McWhorter just said, no, I'm just going to go ahead and score this.
Yeah, she powered through that one.
Yeah. right, 5-8 on the scoreboard. Spring Hill with the lead. Woodlawn with the ball, 1:40 to go in the quarter. Woodlawn swinging it around. Throws it up just a little long. Spring Hill with the rebound, they're gonna push it ahead. Lost it momentarily, gets it back.
That was a great play
to save that from going out of bounds.
And being aware of where she was under the basket.
Yeah. If I was Woodlawn, I'd have probably called a timeout after that one. Three-point shot off, no good, and it'll go back to Spring Hill.
Yeah, Spring Hill has the early momentum here.
Yep.
They might want to slow that down.
Scoring's starting to pick up for Spring Hill anyway. Woodlawn's going to have to pick up some intensity on the defensive end. Really just take care of the ball and get some better shots on the offensive end. Put up a couple of shots. Hadn't been that close. There's a steal right there from Mack. Misses the layup. Spring Hill pulls it out. On the run. 2-on-2. Nice up and under right there. That was a good move right there from Adams. She's going to score the basket. And she'll go to the line for a three-point play.
Completed the old-fashioned three, as they say.
And Spring Hill with an early 10-point lead with 20 seconds left to go in the quarter. Woodlawn can hold for the last shot if they choose.
Yeah.
Looks like they're going to try to.
Shot clock is off.
The quarter with a skip pass. Three-point shot, good. Nice shot by Hysaw. Great ball movement. That'll be the end of the first quarter. It's what started off a little bit slow, but Spring Hill picked up the scoring intensity right there. Spring Hill picked up the scoring a little bit. Woodlawn finally got a shot to fall. And maybe the teams are starting to wake up a little bit for this early game, and they'll get going in the second quarter.
Yeah, I think they're beginning to find their groove a little bit.
It's tough on an early game like this, too, just to kind of get going. Nobody ever, unless you play a tournament on a Saturday, then, you know, throughout the whole season, nobody ever plays this early,
That's right.
And so to get up and on a Saturday and play this early, it's tough.
Especially being away from home.
Yeah, most teenagers are on a Saturday, you know, probably still sleeping this time usually, so. So here we go. We'll start the second quarter. Spring Hill will have the basketball. A 7-point lead.
Looks like both teams come back with their starters to start the quarter.
We're going to get a jump ball to start it off. So, Spring Hill loses it. Go over to Woodlawn. Woodlawn looking to move around. They get it, try to force it in if it's given. And we got bodies on the floor. And we're going to get a jump ball.
McBrayer was a little slow getting up on that one.
So it'll go back over to Spring Hill. Spring Hill fans weren't real happy about that. Wasn't a foul, but I don't think there was a foul there. I think both girls diving on the floor after the ball. Probably the right call, jump ball there. And there's a travel. We see that a lot right there, James, in the girls' game especially. You know, girls will give a little pump fake, and they'll just move those feet just before they put that ball down. And we've had that called quite a bit so far in the tournament.
It's almost like there's an emphasis on that with the officials looking for that.
Yeah, they're definitely looking for it. And there's a little reach-in foul. We're going to get a foul on McBrayer with a little reach-in foul. Going to get a, okay, let's reset the shot clock. And Woodlawn will trigger it in.
Yeah, back to that play. I thought that was good aggressive defense. She didn't pick up the foul.
Yeah. And there's going to be a block. There's Fitzgibbon driving in again.
Yeah, that's her game. She likes to drive and take it to the hole.
Absolutely. She gets the first free throw to fall. Second one goes as well. And Woodlawn cuts into that lead just a little bit. Oh, steal by Holt. Not a good pass there from Spring Hill. Holt's looking to attack. Oh, she gets blocked. Great defense. Now Spring Hill's on the run. They've got numbers. 3-on-1. Kick it over, and Fitzgibbon's going to pick up the foul. And that's going to be Zacharias. No, I'm sorry. That's McBrayer going to the line. She gets the first to go. Misses the second. It's given with the rebound.
She's pushing.
Looks like she I saw on the drive. She's going to kick it out, turn it over. Slow it down and set up the offense. Woodlawn's going to pull it down. And there's a reach-in foul on Adams. There's Fitzgibbon again. Into the rack.
She's looking more and more like she did the first game.
Yeah,
here.
Absolutely. You can tell she feels better. Which is crazy because almost her entire lower leg is about twice the size. Her left is about twice the size of her right one. And so I know she's slower than she would be, but she's starting to look a little more comfortable.
Yeah, and you know she's playing through some pain there.
Oh, absolutely.
She's got a lot of heart.
Woodlawn's going to come up with it. They'll swing it around. Fitzgibbon for three. No good. Ball's knocked out of bounds by Spring Hill. 4-point lead for Spring Hill right now. Woodlawn with the ball. 5 minutes left to go in the half. There's a nice little inbounds play for an opposite three. No good, but Heisaw is there for the rebound. And she'll get the putback. So Woodlawn working their way back into this one right here.
Yeah. That was a good job getting that outside rebound.
Yeah, Spring Hill's going to have to get something going offensively. There's a little pull-up jump shot. No good. Rebound gets tipped around, bounced around. Spring Hill's going to come up with it. Shot up, no good. And then
I think that was
McBrayer is going to get the foul right there. Yep, going over the
push right there, going for that offensive rebound.
Following her shot and jump right into the Woodlawn player.
Yeah, I like her aggressiveness, but she was just a little out of control right there.
It's her second foul, too.
Yep. Yeah, she's going to have to be careful. 4:25 left to go in the half. She doesn't want to pick up that third. She's a big part of Spring Hill's game, so, you know, she doesn't want to pick up that third foul and have to sit any. Loose ball. We're going to get another jump ball. And that's going to stay here with Woodlawn. You know, if I was Fitzgibbon over there in the corner, a nice move by the quarter. Smith is the layup. Good offensive rebound. Block shot. Knocked out of there.
Fitzgibbon had the ball over here. Good basket right there by Spring Hill.
But Fitzgibbon had the ball over here with McBrayer on her. And, you know, Fitzgibbon's pretty good at driving the basket. Block shot there, goes out of bounds. I might have tried to take it at McBrayer to see if I get that third foul.
Yeah, that would have been a smart move there. She did drive it in that time.
Got the block.
Well, the block, out of bounds. Yep. It's her ball.
There's a three-point attempt. Is good. That's Mack on the three. Pulls it to a one-point game. Spring Hill still with the lead. Drive in, ball lost. It's going to hit the baseline. That'll be a turnover by Spring Hill. Spring Hill's going to get a 30-second timeout.
Good idea. Momentum has definitely switched the other way. And
yeah,
they need to talk about it here.
They've still got the one-point lead. 3:15 left to go in the half, but Woodlawn's going to have the ball, and they do have the momentum right now, Woodlawn, so. See what coach can draw up right here. Obviously want to try to get a stop. But we'll see what they can do. Second game tonight,
Mr. Spradlin will be on the boys' side.
We'll have the Woodlawn Bears again on the boys' side against the Junction City Dragons in what's probably going to be a really good game.
There's been some really good games in this recently. The boys, particularly, they've been very competitive.
Yeah.
A lot of very athletic teams. Defense! Defense!
Defense! Defense! Oh, trying to get it down inside. Good defense right there from Thompson. And she takes the ball away. And then Spring Hill throws it away. Back to Woodlawn. Spring Hill got the stop they wanted, but then another turnover. So Fitzgibbon just inside the three-point line, a little bit short.
Spring Hill with a rebound. They're going to push it ahead and almost throw it away again. And ball gets tipped around and they lose it. Woodlawn's going to have the ball.
They're pushing it up. Fitzgibbon looking to turn the corner. She drives in, loses it. Oh, gets blocked out of bounds, but they're going to get a foul.
I'm impressed with her strength on her drive.
Yeah.
She goes hard to the basket. Get your feet planted well, it goes up strong.
That's going to be a foul on Pure Foley for Spring Hill, and that's her third foul. So that's not ideal for Spring Hill, and she's going to have a seat.
It's also the fifth foul, so
I'll be shooting two.
I'll be shooting two the rest of the quarter.
And that free throw right there ties it up for Woodlawn. They will get the miss and a foul on the rebound. Get a little push right there.
As a coach, you hate to see.
Yeah, I know. So all the way over the basket.
Yeah. There wasn't much he was going to be able to do there anyway.
Yeah, Spring Hill had the rebound. So. 3-point shot up. No good. Offensive rebound. Shot up, no good. Quarter. Oh, yeah. The rebound down. They're going to get a jump ball. And Spring Hill grabbed a hold of it also.
The quarter went to the deck hard on that one.
Yeah. Shot up a lot of fun in the quarter right there. And Woodlawn will come away with it. So Woodlawn with a chance to take the lead. 1:50 left to go in the half. Inside in the quarter. She's going to drive through. Just misses. Pretty good defense right there from Spring Hill. Kick over to the corner for three. No good. Mack with the rebound. And Woodlawn, and then she loses it out of bounds.
Yeah, I think both teams are awake now. The intensity has really picked up both ends.
Yep. Scoring's still a little tough to come by. But, yeah, you're right. The intensity is definitely higher in the second quarter than it was in the first. There it is again. They're shuffling those feet. I saw pushing. She's going to kick it over to Fitzgibbon for three. Just off the rim. No good. Offensive rebound. No good. And we're going to get another jump ball.
It'll be Woodlawn's ball out of bounds under their basket.
Under a minute left to go in the half. Nice move to get to the shot right there. No good. Long rebound out to Spring Hill. And now bring it up the floor. Go! 3-point shot up. Really good. The corner with the rebound. Woodlawn's pushing. 22 seconds to go in the half. Here comes Fitzgibbon, trying to get around the corner. She's going to dribble it off of Spring Hill's foot, and it'll go out of bounds, staying here with Woodlawn.
Be a good time for their best inbounds play right here and hit a bucket.
Yep.
18 seconds left in the half.
We'll throw it in, and it's kicked by Spring Hill. So we'll throw it in again. Fifteen seconds left to go. We're gonna have a didn't see that, must be a legal screen or something. Under the basket. We call it on high salt for Woodlawn. And Spring Hill will have the ball and they can take the last shot if they want. She pushes through, tries to dribble through a double team. It's never a good idea. And loses the ball, and then a little bit of a frustration. Spring Hill fans not happy about it. but it is a little bit different scenario. You got two defenders from Woodlawn standing down there, and the Spring Hill player tries to dribble between the two of them while they're standing there. On this end, the Spring Hill player was reaching for the basketball, bump into the person with the ball. So a little bit different scenarios right there.
Missed that first free throw. Can you make this one?
And missed them both, and that'll do it for the first half. So neither team able to pull away here, take the lead. And we'll have a 18-18 score going into halftime in what's been a slow offensive game. And James will be back in about 10 minutes for the second half action.
Yeah, Spring Hill only managed 3 points in that quarter.
Yeah. Okay, we'll see you guys back in just a little bit. All right, basketball fans, we are back for the second half of action of the first game, the final round, the final day of our 2A South Regional Tournament, the third place game on the girls' side between the Spring Hill Lady Bears and the Woodlawn Lady Bears. Spring Hill will start with the ball, and that's going to be the third foul right off the bat on McBrayer. I believe, yep, that's going to be her third foul for Spring Hill, and that's not a good sign for the Bears from Spring Hill, the Blue Bears. She's a big part of their game plan, and so if she has to come out, that's going to hurt them a little bit. Ball's tip stays here with Woodlawn.
So far, this has proved to be another very competitive game here, these regional games we've been getting to watch.
Yeah, you know, we talked about the scoring might not be as high as it has been. Intensity took a minute, but both teams pretty much, you know, evenly matched here. Woodlawn's going to throw it ahead to Fitzgibbon, and she steps out of bounds. The ball is just a little too long from Holt right there. Our next game this afternoon on the boys' side between the Junction City Dragons and the Woodlawn Bears, probably going to prove to be a good one too. Either one of those teams last night could have been playing in the finals tonight. We'll get a travel right there.
The triple pirouette move there.
Yeah. You only can do a double pirouette in basketball. She's trying to go with the triple.
You're right on that boys' game. Either team could have been playing in the finals tonight.
Yeah. Junction City, very well coached. I really like their coach. He's a first-year guy.
I didn't know he was a first-year guy. I'm impressed.
Yeah.
Even more impressed. You're right.
Dixon's going to pick up her third foul, so she's going to come sit down. She didn't play much in that first half. She picked up two in the first quarter and comes in right away and picks up a third. So, yeah, and then Woodlawn last night, their size is impressive. They're the biggest team here. They can go to the bench and get bigger. And so, ought to be a good game in that second one. If both teams show up, you know, like we said, this third place game is tough sometimes. But both teams show up to play, wanting to win this game, then it ought to be a good one. So Spring Hill is going to bring McBrayer out for just a little bit.
Be interesting to see how long they leave her on the bench.
Yeah. Almost a turnover. Woodlawn keeps it. Skip it over. Looking nice pass right there. Good extra pass. McWhorter brings it just a little bit short. Rebound for Spring Hill and the outlet. Oh, sold the layup. Missed it. Needed that one right there.
They did. That was a good pass.
Fitzgibbon trying to weave through traffic. Comes up with a double dribble. Woodlawn's coach wanting her girls to calm down. So they're getting a little out of control right there.
I believe she's a first-year coach, too.
Is she? And then a timeout from Spring Hill. He's going to talk about it.
Yeah, that was, I thought was going to be another walk, too. Yeah. That was maybe a very timely.
He may have called that timeout right before the walk was called, yeah. Because it may happen again right there. So no baskets yet to start this second half. You know, the scores have been slow the whole game so far. You know these girls are tired. We know Woodlawn's banged up. Long trips, long days. So you kind of expect this usually.
Yeah, this may turn into an endurance match. Whichever team can still have some go at the end will win it.
Whoever's got just a little bit left in the tank at the end. Purifoy there, still in the game for Spring Hill. She's playing with three fouls also. Ball was tipped right there. They're going to call a foul on Fitzgibbon with a little push. Her second. Ball in for three. No good. Tipped over. Spring Hill gets it back again. No good. Woodlawn's going to pull away. Holt's on the move. She's weaving through traffic. Looks like she's going to attack. She's taking it at Purifoy. Purifoy is going to pick up the foul. That's going to be her fourth. And the basket goes for Holt on a nice drive and a move. And she's going to go to the line.
They have McBrayer coming back in her place.
Yeah, and she's got Purifoy's three. Place. So they're going to have to be careful.
Scott, I was impressed with that drive by Holt.
Yeah.
She's really favoring that right arm, and she's using it just only when she has to, but she went in and with her left one finished the shot.
Missed the free throw, but on the rebound, we get a jump ball, and they'll stay with Woodlawn. There's a three-point attempt. No good. Springhill gets the rebound, and she gets bumped from behind by Mack. Another foul down here 90 feet from the basket.
Yes. I think she had the one in the first half, too.
Lob over the top. Fitzgibbon is right there in front of her. And as the Spring Hill, who's that over there? That was Tyree over there going for the lob. I guess Fitzgibbon just bumped into her. Couldn't really see it. It's on the other side from us. And it's like Fitzgibbon bumped into her. That's her third foul, so she's going to come to the bench, take a break.
Fouls are starting to add up a little bit.
Yeah.
So
the quarter on the steal. So there's Holt again driving in. Couldn't get it to go this time. And Adams goes coast to coast, misses the layup. Woodlawn comes out of there with it. And they're going to slow it down just a little bit. I thought they threw it away right there. I didn't see the corner.
No, they've got it. That was almost a sliding soccer tackle by Holt on this other end.
Yeah, she came in hot. McWhorter trying to save it. Can't quite get it in. They're going to have a couple subs in for Spring Hill. With the lead.
I believe that's her first lead of the game, too.
Yep. Spring Hill going in strong. Ball's grabbed. Can't get up. McWhorter is going to pull it down. And Spring Hill's going to get a foul.
That was a good job at McWhorter. She avoided the over-the-back foul, the push in the back. And got a second chance at a rebound then and grabbed the board.
Yeah.
And then drew the foul herself.
There's a tip ball. We get a sub in right here for Woodlawn. This is Melbourne. First playing minutes for her tonight, or this afternoon. Screen. Pull up no good. Ball's going to get tipped out on Woodlawn. It'll go back to Spring Hill. So both teams, due to some foul trouble, getting to their benches early in the second half. 3:25 left to go in the third. Shot up. No good. Big rebound right there. Oh, throws it away. Spring Hill's going to have it. That's Zacharias with the steal and the basket to tie the game back up. Ooh. Holton with a drive right there, split the defenders and tried to pass it off to McWhorter. She wasn't ready for it, and it goes out of bounds. And we're going to get a bump right there. Looks like Holt's a little frustrated. We're going to pick up a frustration foul. Be her second. She'll come have a seat for just a minute. And Spring Hill's going to go to the line for two shots. James, what do you think about the doing away with the one-and-ones and things like that in basketball, and just going two shots after five free throws?
I don't know. I've
been doing that for a while now, but boys haven't they? But the boys get
no.
It's just changed for both.
Yeah, it's. I don't know. At the beginning of the year, I was a little surprised when I heard that was going to be a rule this year, the change of the rule. I think I kind of like it actually, though. It does take a little bit away from the old one and one. You got to make that first one pressure. Old school purists might still want that in play, but I think it has helped with keeping the flow of the game going a little better. I think. I don't know.
Okay, so we're getting a few comments in the chat. This is Woodlawn's coach's first year, so first year here at Woodlawn. And they're telling me, thanks, Grace. What I got in the book was an L, not a Y, but that's Hoyt, not Holt. Number four for Woodlawn. So I apologize for that, but that was somebody else's bad handwriting, not mine.
Handwriting matters, doesn't it, Coach?
Yep. Here we go. Spin move there. Good defense. We're going to get Coach from Woodlawn. We're going to get a timeout. Looked like McWhorter might have been in a little bit of trouble there on the rebound, and she's caused a timeout. Probably a good timeout. Got plenty of them to go. 1:28 left to go in the third. 20-20 game. Still tied up. And it'll be Woodlawn ball here in just a second coming out of the timeout. So, yeah, I'm a little torn on the free throw situation. I kind of like the idea of putting that extra, you know, it takes a little pressure off the shooting team, and I like the pressure, you know.
Yeah.
Because if you got that one and one, you don't make that first one, then, you know.
And it definitely changes your strategy at the end of the game, you
Absolutely.
Know, if you're still just in the one and one. Now you're giving up two free throws on the foul.
Looks like McBrayer is checking back in and the next dead ball for Spring Hill. Basket. And so Woodlawn takes the lead here late in the third. Oh, and Spring Hill's going to throw it away. McBrayer checking back in now for Spring Hill, and she's going to have to be smart and not pick up any more fouls.
Yeah, a lot of coaching strategy going on right now is with the foul situation on both teams. Woodlawn right now playing without Hoyt and
Fitzgibbon both.
Fitzgibbon, yeah.
A block on the basket. Spring Hill, and that's on McBrayer.
It's also a good time to go to your bench. Right now, those legs are probably feeling pretty tired.
going to be McBrayer's fourth, so she's going to come back to the bench. Three-point shot from the
corner. Good by Mack again. And that's back-to-back big threes from Mack. Gives Woodlawn their biggest lead of the game. Drive in for... Get a foul on the foul on Tyree under the basket. Okay, so that's going to send Melhorn to the line. First free throw, no good. Gets the second one. Springhill looking to attack. Shot up, no good, in the lane. 9 seconds left to go in the third quarter.
Oh, big shot.
That's what I was about to say. If I was Mack right there, I'd probably let that three fly after just hitting two in a row. So that gives Woodlawn their biggest lead of the game so far. They're up 9 right here at the end of the third quarter. And it looks like for Spring Hill that Purifoy and McBrayer were checking back in right here. So both with 4 fouls. They're both going to come back in to start the fourth quarter. Probably a good move from Spring Hill to get those girls back in. They just got to be careful. Don't pick up that fifth.
I'm just looking at the quarter scores here. After the first quarter from there to now, Woodlawn's on a 21-5 run points-wise.
So definitely started to pick up the scoring. Start the fourth quarter. Spring Hill with the ball. Almost loses it. Turnaround shot up. No good. Rebound by Hysaw, and Woodlawn is going to stick with the same lineup.
Oh, I thought she was going to pull it.
Woodlawn still has Hoyt and Fitzgibbon on the bench right now, so there's McWhorter going up. She'll get fouled.
You know, with a 9-point lead, I think I would leave those two on the bench for a little while and rest some more.
Yeah, I definitely. They kind of took the lead with them sitting on the bench. So, go with what works right now. And it's working. McWhorter misses the first free throw. Good. 10-point lead now for Woodlawn. Let's see if Spring Hill can get something going. Just takes a basket or two, and they're right back in it. Get a score here, get a stop and a score, and you are in it. And that's going to be an offensive foul on 5 on Thompson. She did. She took the forearm right into the gut right there and pushed it. That Spring Hill not happy about it, but that absolutely was the right call there. She made her own space with a little forearm. And that's her fourth foul, so Spring Hill's now got 3 girls with 4 fouls. Defense!
try to take it in, and she's going to lose it. It's going to go back over to Spring Hill. Take right there by Thompson. She'll get fouled. They're going to call the foul on Mack there. And that looks like that's going to be her.
Fifth. It's her second.
First free throw, no good. Got a little confusion at the sports table, but we got it. All right, so we got it. Yep, just a little confusion right there, and we'll get back here. So we'll have the second free throw. Second free throw is good.
Woodlawn calls the timeout. It's a much-needed free throw from Spring Hill. Maybe that'll break the ice. Get some scoring going again.
Yep.
Like you were saying earlier, they really need a stop and a score and a stop to climb back in this thing.
Yep. And it doesn't take much. 9-point game.
Six and a half minutes left. It's plenty of time left.
One thing that we used to always to harp on and talk about, we're coaching, is getting stops and, getting three stops in a row. Some people call it a kill or a turkey, like in bowling, you get three strikes in a row. And with a low-scoring game like this, it's very doable for Spring Hill to come out and get three stops here. And if they do and are able to come down and score, then, it's a ball game. So we still got plenty of time, 6:29 left to go in the game, so no reason to panic. And we'll come out of the timeout here. And it'll be Woodlawn ball. Spring Hill will put on a little pressure. Dixon back in the game for Woodlawn. She hadn't been in a minute. Picked up her third foul early. And Fitzgibbon back in as well for Woodlawn. So, had the stop right there. Missed the shot, but couldn't get the rebound.
Yeah. Missed opportunity for sure. Spring Hill's extending their pressure a little bit.
Here's Fitzgibbon, shot no good. Spring Hill with the rebound, there you go, got the outlet. That's Adams on the run out. She's going to get a layup, no contest.
There's a stop and a score.
Yep, there's one. See if they can get another one. Open shot in the corner. No good, but the rebound by McCorder. She's going to get fouled. And she'll go to the line to shoot two. Got the stop again, but again, the offensive rebound. Porter misses the free throw. She had the ball to me. right there. And that's Fitzgibbon's fourth. 5:30 left to go, so Fitzgibbon's going to check out. No doubt she'll probably be back in here in just a couple minutes, but
yeah.
While Woodlawn's got the lead, that's not a terrible idea. They still got a good lead. Get Fitzgibbon out. Make sure she doesn't pick up that fifth so she can be in at the end of the game. Three-point shot, no good from Spring Hill.
That was another one of those 90 feet away from the basket fouls, though.
Woodlawn in the quarter with a big offensive rebound. Again, got the stop. Offensive rebound, and they get the score. And we're going to come down on this end, and the quarter trying to pick up the charge. Sliding down, she's going to pick up the block instead, and Thompson is going to go to the line to shoot two.
Made the first one.
Second one, no good. Offensive rebound. McWhorter throws that one out of bounds. Good block there by McWhorter. Stay with it and not pick up a foul. She just picked up a foul a while ago. You hate to pick up fouls back to back. Did a good job defensively there. Spring Hill will keep it. 4:52 left to go in the game. Oh, and Spring Hill turns around and throws it out of bounds.
Unforced turnover there. That hurts your cause.
Yeah. If you're Woodlawn, you gotta think, let's run some clock. Let's get that shot clock down.
Or take the three.
Max is gonna take that three.
They get the offensive board.
Yeah, she's with offensive rebound, and she's gonna get fouled. You got to be thinking, though, time is of the essence here, and you want to try to milk it.
Absolutely. Two of your best players are on the bench. And
yeah.
With fouls, you need to burn that clock and get it down where you can bring them back in and finish it.
Yeah. Dixon misses the first free throw.
Spring Hill with the timeout.
You definitely don't want to take tough shots right now if you're Woodlawn. Not that that one wasn't a tough shot. Mac was open. Probably would have been, they may have been upset with her if she didn't shoot that as well as she shot this game so far. But, you can get a tough shot at any time in the shot clock.
That's right.
At 2 seconds left on the clock, you can put up a tough one. So you don't want to take tough shots early in the shot clock if you're Woodlawn. You want to definitely milk that clock and get it down. And
yes, right now work the ball around and get the – easy basket if you can, near the basket. That's a premium there. If you burn the shot clock and then can't get that, then take that shot.
Yep. So we got 4:25 left to go in the game. 8-point lead for Woodlawn. Is at the line. Dixon at the line to shoot one more free throw. Up, good. Spring Hill with the ball. Clock's down at 4 minutes. Spring Hill loses the ball. Hightsaw comes away with it. She's looking to push it. Gets it down inside. Shot up. Tough shot, no good. Spring Hill pulls it out.
That might have been a good time to pull it out, work the clock again.
I think so. That was a little bit of a tough shot right there. Connor. And there's a foul by McWhorter. She knew it. Kind of ran right through her right there. You know, and if you're Woodlawn also, you don't want a foul. You probably don't need a gamble for that. Because now, that's your last foul to give. Next time, Spring Hill's in the bonus. So they're going to shoot free throws the rest of the way out.
Which stops the clock and gives them a chance for points.
You'd like to have that extra foul late in the game to foul. And there you go. There's a foul. Clock stop, 3:23. And Spring Hill's going to be able to have a chance to cut into this lead.
Right now, if you're Woodlawn, you just want to keep them in front of you. Step between them, the goal.
Make them take tough shots.
Yeah.
Walk out, rebound, take care of the ball. On the other hand, Spring Hill's doing probably exactly what they need to do. They're pushing it, trying to get to that free throw line.
Yeah, now they would be wise to drive it and try to give fouls every trip down.
Yep.
Made both free throws.
I think if Spring Hill's going to have a chance to win this one, though, they're going to have to block out and rebound down here on the defensive end.
That's right.
That's been Woodlawn's an asset for Woodlawn here in the second half for sure. They hadn't been making the first shot, but they're getting the second one. Nixon takes it in. Going to get blocked. It'll go out of bounds. 3:01 left to go.
14 on the shot clock. That was good defense there by Spring Hill.
Yep. I believe that was Purifoy with the block. She's got four fouls. Don't reach. The drive by Hysaw up off the glass. Good. That's a nice drive right there from Hysaw. That was a pretty good possession for Woodlawn right there.
It was. They used a lot of the shot clock and got a good drive.
McWhorter saves the rebound. Woodlawn's pushing it.
Score here might be big. Oh, good.
Tip from behind. It's going to hit the end line and go out of bounds. And here comes Fitzgibbon. She's going to check back in. So 2:32 left to go. Fitzgibbon's going to come back in. That's going to be big for Woodlawn. Senior, leader, good free throw shooter, good foul drawer. Ball was tipped right there. Spring Hill comes away with it. We're going to go over the back. Court. Yep, yeah. That's right. Right call.
She's just a victim of place there. Yeah.
Bad circumstance.
Good steal, but good hustle on her part.
Yeah, just happened at the wrong spot. Nice take right there from five. That's Thompson. I like that little over-the-top rip right there. And she gets the foul. That's four on McWhorter now. So we got 2:15 left to go.
Yeah, she's going to get a little break here.
Yep.
It takes a big rebounder off the floor for Woodlawn.
Yep. Gets them both. But with about 2 minutes left to go, you also can kind of live with that a little bit because you want ball handlers, free throw shooters in the game for Woodlawn. And, you know, you lose a little bit on rebound. Oh, there's a travel. Oh, again, from Mac. Just got to calm down.
We might start seeing the offense for defense substitutions.
Yep.
Or vice versa.
2 minutes to go. See if Spring Hill can chip back away a little bit. Nice move right there. There's the basket. Good move from McBrayer.
Gets it to a five-point game.
Just like that, you get a couple stops and a couple scores.
Got pressure the ball.
Woodlawn's going to get a timeout on you.
It's a good timeout for them, I think.
1:41 left to go.
Mm-hmm.
Woodlawn with a 5-point lead. Sorry, Ron, I'm not on the camera. There's 1:41 left to go. When it gets close to the end here, I'll try to keep you updated on the time. I'm just down at the computer. I got a student up running the camera, so we'll try to do the best to keep you updated. All right, so here we go. Woodlawn ball with the lead. You got to think after this one, Spring Hill's probably going to have to start fouling. If they can't, got a trap right here and a turnover. And that's going to be a foul on Woodlawn. Down here again away from the basket, that's Matt. With a push.
Third foul on Mac.
Yeah, and Spring Hill's going to walk down the other end and shoot free throws. So,
with 1:34 left in the game.
If she makes these right here, then... missed the first. Got the second.
4-point game.
4-point game. Mike can go one more possession without fouling if you get the stop here.
With the shot clock, yeah. Yeah.
I definitely want the ball in Fitzgibbon's hands. She's going to drive in. She's going to get fouled. And one of those two girls just fouled out. I don't know who they're going to call the foul on. It looks like McBrayer hit the deck pretty hard. And I think that's going to be the foul on her, and that'll be her fifth. So she looks like she's in a little bit of pain on the floor.
Looks hopefully like she might okay. have hit that shoulder.
Yeah, laid it on her shoulder. And McBrayer fouls out. That's a big one for Spring Hill. And Fitzgibbon's gonna go to the line for two.
Woodlawn's ringing the quarterback in the game.
She's got four fouls, so she's gotta be careful. First free throw up and good. For Fitzgibbon.
Five-point game, 36-31.
Misses the second. Spring Hill with a rebound.
And they push the ball.
1:15 left to go. Ball gets tipped. It's going to stay here. 1:13 on the clock.
Big possession here for Spring Hill.
Spring Hill really needs a basket. There's a three. This would be a big one. Just off the back of the iron. No good. Dixon with a rebound. Woodlawn's pushing. She's going to get bumped right there, which is okay if you're Spring Hill.
Yeah.
Dixon's going to go to the line and shoot two. Foul's going to be on Cantwell. That's her first, so. Dixon at the line to shoot two. Misses the first one. Lock out. 1:07 left to go. Second one is good. 6 point game. Now for Woodlawn. Over the top. McWhorter with a good defense. They were trying to get it down into Thompson, had a lane to throw it over the top, but Fitzgibbon came in from behind. Ball didn't quite get high enough. McWhorter goes up, tips it out. So
So good defense right there by Woodlawn. Defense! 58 seconds left to go. Good shot right there by Adams. Spring Hill's going to get a timeout. She gets the bucket to go. 50 seconds left.
4-point game, 37-33.
Get a timeout for Spring Hill. So, 4-point game, 50 seconds left. I would imagine you got to try for a quick steal. If not, you got to get the foul.
Yeah.
So,
being a two-possession game like that, you got to.
Yeah.
Spring Hill has one timeout left, and Woodlawn has two.
So, good game to start day three, or day four of the tournament, round three, I guess.
Now, once again, I've been really impressed with the quality of games that we've gotten to see.
Pretty good matches, pretty good matchups all the way around. Fans getting excited for both teams here. 50 seconds left to go. Woodlawn's going to throw the ball in. Pressure right here from Spring Hill. They're going to let him throw it into McWhorter. She's going to hold it. Eating the clock. Oh, and they throw it away. It gets tipped by Spring Hill.
Can't burn too much time, 90 feet from the basket. You still got to get across the center line.
Yeah, absolutely. Throw it up to Hysaw. Nice catch right there by Hysaw. She's driving in. Nice pass over to McWhorter for a layup.
Good finish.
That was a good job right there from Woodlawn. Now just don't foul if you're Woodlawn, and you're probably going to come away with it. 27 seconds left. Shot up, no good. Rebound by Woodlawn. Mack with the board, and that's going to be a foul. She's going to walk to the other end to shoot free throws. 23 seconds left to go.
Frustrated with herself. She missed that layup.
Yep. She'll want that one back.
That was her fourth foul, too.
Shot up and good from Matt.
7-point lead, 23.5 seconds. It's not looking good for Spring Hill at this point.
Shot missed, ball tipped out, and Woodlawn's going to get the long rebound. So that'll probably do it right there. So they'll foul. 17 seconds left. Hysaw's going to go to the line. That's the fifth foul there for Adams.
It is.
But she had to, so. Seven-point lead. At the line to add to it. I saw misses the first free throw.
Leaves a tiny crack open there for Spring Hill. The missed free throw.
Gets that one. Clock ticking, 15, 10, jump ball on the floor. Going to go back to Woodlawn, 9 seconds left, and that's going to be all she wrote. Spring Hill calling the dogs off.
Yeah, they're not going to foul.
So Woodlawn will be your 3 seed coming out of the 2A South tournament. Good game from both teams.
Good game. Good effort from both squads.
And we'll be back here in just a few minutes for the third place game for the boys. Mr. Spradlin, appreciate you helping me out.
Oh, no problem. I enjoyed it.
And we'll see you guys back in just a few minutes.